Hi everyone, welcome to my channel. I'm Gina, and guess where I've been? I went to Dollar Tree, and man, they have really expanded their craft section. There are a lot of videos online about this. That's what got me excited and wanting to go and take a look at the Dollar Trees around me. And let me tell you, first off, it depends on the store. Each store carries different items, at least that's been my experience. The one I usually go to had a much smaller section, and so I ventured out to another one, which I knew the store was a little larger, and what a huge difference it made, and that's where I got all of these items. I read in February of this year, 2021, that the Dollar Tree was really going to expand its craft section with the Crafter's Square products, and boy did they. So I just had this haul last night, and before I tore into anything and started using it, I thought I'd do a haul video and just show some of these items to you first. So let's take a closer look at each item. All right, I'm gonna start with the stamps. Why? Because this is really the reason I wanted to go to that store. My store did not carry stamps, and I had seen other videos where they got these great stamps, and I really wanted to check it out for myself and see what kind of stamps they offered. And this location had some. Now, these were the only three that they had. I don't know if they normally have more, or maybe these are just the standard ones that they carry. I don't really know, but you can believe that I will go back again and again just to check it out and see what else they have to offer. But look how cute. Is that not so sweet? I mean, this one you get 12 pieces for a dollar. I mean, that's just fantastic. And they're just adorable images. Look at that. Kiss, kiss, love, love. That's great for Valentine's and just any kind of lovey-dovey sentiment. And look at the dream catchers. That's just adorable. Catch your dream, be brave. I really love collecting sentiments through various stamp collections. This one has llamas and cacti, but look, dream, hello. Of course, I love llama. Be brave, catch your dream. And then of course, you know, kiss and love, I love you. This is a great way to collect a nice range of sentiment stamps. Next on my list was stickers. Now, I have previously bought a ton of stickers from the dollar store. Before Crafter's Square came along, they had the Jot stickers. They're just gorgeous. You know, I mean, they're 3D, they're dimensional, and they were just beautiful, and they had a big variety. So I have been buying stickers at the dollar store for quite some time. Now that I do a lot more with paper products, with journaling and such, I was really on the lookout for flatter stickers, not so dimensional. Of course, I could not help myself in some cases because it was just adorable and I could envision using them. I'm trying to be more careful about what I purchase, even from the dollar store, because over time you collect so much. So now I try to be careful and really think, will I use it? And not just go for that impulse purchase because I saw it and it looks neat. So I did buy these. These are dimensional, but they aren't big and bulky dimensional. They're still fairly thin. So I went ahead and purchased those because, I mean, yeah, look how cool. Is that not awesome? I love the images, and I could definitely see using them. These were a lot more flat. I mean, they are kind of dimensional. You can feel like all the little ridges, but they are super flat, and so I thought that would be great to use when I don't want a whole lot of bulk and I'm going for that nice flat finish, but also want to add something interesting to the piece. I mean, look at that. Isn't that neat? I just love them. So I grabbed the different ones of these that I could find. In that same area, they had rub-on transfers. So I grabbed a couple of those, and that is just fantastic. This is something you would pay at least $3.99, $4.99 for at any other store. And it's for a dollar, and there's just tons of different little sayings, and it's so cute. So I grabbed these because rub-ons are fun. If you're working on a flat project, like a paper project for a journal, maybe a journal card, and you don't want anything bulky, rub-ons are the perfect thing to use. Now these items really surprised me. I knew they had other wooden items there before. I just bought these not long ago from my regular Dollar Tree store because I thought, oh, that's just so adorable. I could definitely alter these. So I knew they had this type of product there, but I had not seen the laser cut words yet. I was super happy to see these. Again, this is a $3.99 product that I would normally get in Hobby Lobby, and I got them for a dollar. So that is awesome. I was stunned to see this item. Oil pastels. I mean, really? So I have not tried any of these yet. I just bought them last night, and I'm sure I will do a video on those because I can't wait to compare them. They are a dollar item, and you have to keep that in mind, right? When you have your expectation. So I'm not forgetting that, but hey, if it works great, then what a wonderful option for people who are really on a tight budget but want to express themselves through these products. This is an item I was really excited to see and can't wait to try. Now these little bits, the jump rings and the lobster claws, I have not used or created items that use these products very often. This was one of those purchases where I was like, okay, it's a dollar. If I get into using them, what a great price to have purchased them at. So I went ahead and grabbed them. The same thing goes with this little tape. I just thought it was cute. I have a ton of washi tape, and that's, again, an item I don't always use very often, so I was really cautious about not just grabbing a bunch more. But I thought the pattern was cute, and I could see possibly using that on something bright and cheery. The cutting die was another item that I was really excited about that I had seen on a previous video and hoped that I could locate in the dollar store near me. And I did. I found this one. It's cute. There's an example of the edges that you could get from using it. And for a dollar, I mean, come on. They work with most die cutting machines. And, you know, even if you only use them a couple of times, it's still worth it. They also had some stretch lace. Now, granted, these colors are kind of bold and not some that I would use normally. But what made me buy this is that the project I was just making yesterday, I was just doing on my own for fun. It was this little book. As you can see, I was using this beautiful paper, and it is purple. And look, both of these would have matched perfectly as a closure. And so I thought, you know what? Even though it's not a color I use a lot, when you need something in that color, then you need something in that color. For a dollar, I might as well pick it up and have it on hand for when I need it. Okay, the last pieces that I picked up were these, and honestly, I would probably just use them as binding for journals, is my guess. Possibly in some mixed media art as well. But I like the colors. These colors are ones that I know I would use fairly often. So I thought, let me just go ahead and have it on hand in case I need it. So these were the items that I bought. Now they had a ton of other items. They have lots of beads, and they even had a bead organizer tray. So for those of you who work with beads, that tray would be super awesome and handy. They actually had air dry clay. Now that is an item that I use, but I have so much of it right now, it just didn't seem worth even for a dollar to purchase more. But it's great to know that it's there if I want to go back. And I would definitely be interested to see how it holds up against some more expensive air dry clay. So it might be worth picking up some, if nothing else, just to compare them, maybe do a video about that. But there were lots of other wooden objects. They had googly eyes and pom-poms. They have glues and mounting squares. They even have small bottles of Mod Podge. They have stencils, and I have bought stencils there before. The ones they had just weren't anything that I needed right now. And again, tons of stickers. They had a huge selection of yarn. These were just the colors that I got, but they had a variety of different colors. So if you knit or do any kind of craft that uses yarn, crochet, anything like that, then check out your local dollar store. They have a great selection. I hope you found this video informative. If you did, give me that thumbs up. and leave your comment. What other items have you purchased from your local dollar store that I didn't show or talk about? I really would love to know. All right, that's it for this one. I'll see you in the next video. Bye.